What's 0 to the power 0? 0 with a positive exponent equals 0, but a positive number to the 0 power is 1. So is 0 to the 0 equal to 0 or 1, or is it undefined? Let's explore this quantity in 5 levels, ranging from the meaning of exponents to calculus and beyond. For level 1, let's look at how Euler, one of the greatest mathematicians in history, defined 0 to the 0. In his book from 1752, he defined a to the 0 equals 1, and specifically mentioned that 0 to the 0 equals 1. In the 1787 version of his book, Mascheroni added this justification. See what you think of it. 0 to the 0 equals a minus a to the n minus n. Then let's turn this into a fraction with the positive part of the exponent in the numerator and the negative part in the denominator. We have a minus a to the n over a minus a to the n, which cancel out to give 1. Okay, this justification doesn't really work, since the fraction we just tried to cancel out is actually 0 over 0. Even though this justification is flawed, Euler's definition that 0 to the 0 equals 1 actually does make sense in many contexts. For level 2, let's think about what exponents mean. When we write 3 to the power 2, we mean to multiply 3 times 3. We have a product made up of two factors of 3. To get 3 to the power 1, we need to remove one of those 3s. We can divide by 3 to do this. We're left with a product of a single factor of 3. To get 3 to the power 0, we divide by 3 again and are left with 1. Another way to say this is that an empty product, a product with no factors, is equal to 1. This is because 1 is the multiplicative identity. So we can interpret a to the 0 as the empty product, which is 1, and 0 to the 0 can also be interpreted as an empty product, which is 1. We can also interpret exponents in terms of counting. Imagine we want to find all of the ordered pairs x, y, where x and y are both chosen from the set 1, 2, 3. It's okay if x equals y. How many of these ordered pairs are there? We have 3 possible choices for x and 3 possible choices for y, so we get 3 squared total pairs. 3 squared counts the number of ordered pairs that can be made from a set of 3 elements. Then 3 to the power 1 would be the number of ways to pick a single number from the set 1, 2, 3. We can call these 1 tuples. They're ordered sequences of 1 element. Or in programming, you could think of this as a list of length 1. So then what is 3 to the 0? This is the number of 0 tuples that we can make from the set 1, 2, 3. Since a 0 tuple has no elements, there's only one possibility, the empty tuple. Or in programming, you might think of this as an empty list. So 3 to the 0 power equals 1. Now what about 0 to the 0? This is the number of 0 tuples we can make from the empty set. There's still one possibility, the empty tuple. So in this context, it makes sense to define 0 to the 0 as 1. For level 3, let's think about polynomials and calculus. Polynomials are continuous functions, meaning they don't have any abrupt changes, like jumps or vertical asymptotes. We can draw any part of their graph in one motion without lifting our pen. X to the 0 is equal to 1 for every positive and negative value of x, so in order for x to the 0 to be a continuous polynomial, we need to define 0 to the 0 equals 1. This definition will also help with the power rule for derivatives. The derivative tells us the slope of a function at a point, like how a car's speedometer shows the speed the car is traveling at that specific moment. The derivative of x to the n is n times x to the n minus 1. This rule actually works for any real exponent n. But what happens if n equals 1? We get that the derivative of x to the 1 equals 1 times x to the 0. Since x is a linear function, we can find its slope with algebra. This line has slope 1. This matches the calculation since x to the 0 equals 1. But in order for this rule to work for x equals 0, we need 0 to the 0 to be 1. Otherwise, the power rule would work for all values of n and x except for n equals 1 and x equals 0. It's just more convenient to define 0 to the 0 equals 1. And there are other formulas like this. The binomial theorem, the geometric series formula, and this Taylor series expansion of e to the x, all of these formulas only work when x equals 0 if we define 0 to the 0 to be 1. For level 4, let's talk about a reason that we might not want to define 0 to the 0 to be 1. In calculus, we learn how to take limits of functions. For continuous functions, we can find a limit by just plugging in the value. For example, to find the limit as x approaches 3 of x over x plus 1, we can just plug in 3 for x to get 3 over 3 plus 1, or 3 fourths. But limits get trickier when we encounter indeterminate forms. For example, say we want to find the limit of log of x over 2x minus 2 as x approaches 1. If we try to plug in x equals 1, we get log of 1, which is 0, divided by 2 times 1 minus 2, which is also 0. 0 divided by 0 is an indeterminate form. Limits that look like this can evaluate to any real number, or even infinity, and so we have to do some extra work to figure them out. It turns out that limit is 1/2. 0 to the 0 is another indeterminate form. Let's look at a couple limits with this form. The limit as x approaches 0 from the positive side of x to the x is 1. But if we take the same limit of the function e to the negative 1 over t to the t, we get e to the negative 1. That function actually just simplifies to e to the negative 1 by multiplying the exponents. Limits of the form 0 to the 0 can have all sorts of different answers, so we say that 0 to the 0 is an indeterminate form. As an algebraic quantity, it often makes sense for us to define 0 to the 0 equals 1, but as a limiting form, 0 to the 0 is indeterminate. Because of this, some calculus books avoid defining 0 to the 0 to avoid confusion when we encounter limits that look like 0 to the 0. For level 5, let's think about x to the y as a function of two variables. To start with, we'll require x to be positive, but y can be any real number. This is a nice continuous function on this region. To define 0 to the 0, we might try to extend this function in a continuous way to the point 0, 0. To be a continuous extension, we should be able to approach the point 0, 0 along any path and always get the same limit. If we approach along the positive x-axis, then the y value is always 0, so the function simplifies to x to the 0, which is 1 since x is positive. Approaching along this path, the limit should be 1. But if we approach along another path, the limit may not be 1. We actually saw an example of this in level 4. The limit of e to the negative 1 over t to the t is e to the negative 1 as t approaches 0 from the positive side. So no matter what value we pick to define 0 to the 0, this is not going to be a continuous extension of the function x to the y. Defining 0 to the 0 equals 1 makes sense in a lot of contexts, but it's important to remember that 0 to the 0 is still an indeterminate form for limits. Understanding 0 to the 0 involves mathematical ideas ranging from algebra to calculus and beyond. A free and easy way to explore these ideas and many others is with Brilliant, the sponsor of this video. With Brilliant, you learn by doing, exploring thousands of interactive lessons in math, data analysis, programming, and AI. Brilliant allows you to build your understanding from the ground up, playing with new concepts and solving problems. For example, instead of just reading the definition of correlation, you engage with this concept and build a deeper understanding of what correlation is. With Brilliant, you learn by problem solving, not memorizing. By learning a little each day in a few spare minutes, Brilliant helps you build your knowledge. The last couple days, I played with our new course, How Large Language Models Work. In this course, you interact with several large language models, including one that was trained on terms and conditions documents, and another that's trained on a cookbook. By exploring these models, you learn the importance of the training data in creating an LLM. You can also explore how the model chooses its next word and how to fine-tune a model to generate specific output, like a poem or a legal document. To try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/drshawn or click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Thanks so much for watching. Let us know your thoughts about 0 to the 0 in the comments, and I'll see you next time.